Hi, it's December. Also, I cut my hair. I don't know how it's gonna go, but it seems fine. I think I cut the bangs bits shorter than the other bits. Like it, but whatever. It goes up in a ponytail. It's also my hair. Deal with the train. It's December. I'm flipping this. December, and the train's gone. Sticky advent calendar. Ooh, I'm so excited. Day one. You're gonna see it before I do. Oh my god, that's gorgeous. Wait. Okay, I need to close the pocket. Come on, cat, you can do it. Come on, cat, you can do it. I don't think it's gonna focus. Oh, there's like really cool dragon. There's a mermaid. There's a tent, a dragon. Whatever these creatures are. So I've decided what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get the stickers and then every day I'm gonna make page in my planner, or almost every day that I feel like it, I'm gonna make a page in my planner with those stickers, because last time I just didn't use the stickers because I didn't want to use them, but it's more fun to use them and make a spread. So I'm gonna look at these. We've got green and pink and gold, so I'm gonna go look at my washi tape and then I'll show you how I make a spread, I guess. It's time to go. I still don't know how I feel about that. I don't know. I'll get used to it. I kind of want to make it go shorter, but you know, it can go shorter, but it can't go longer, so I can't go too short all at once. Unlike the sides, which I totally just shave. Actually, the more I look at it, the better it is. So we'll see. I made my planner. It's very pretty. I like it. What I like the most about the advent calendar is that it doesn't just have Christmas stickers in it. It has stickers that you can use whenever in it, which I think is real cool, because like, what am I gonna do with 25 sheets of just holiday stickers? These ones I can use year round. Some of them are even more like spring, summer, which I appreciate. So what I do need to get is more organizers. Either I need to get more organizers for my sticky guy, my little binder that has all my stickers in it, or I need to find places for these stickers within the categories that I already have, which I could do. I just don't know if I want to right now. Next step is dyeing my hair. I should have dyed it before I cut it, but I had the scissors and I didn't have the hair dye, so this is what we're going with. I cut my hair more. I like this length better. Boy, let me tell you, we are struggling today. You can see where I slept. I might cut more, but who knows? We shall see. I'm gonna get it wet, see how it curls. My chair is sinking. Day two, very excited. The thing I like about short hair is I just woke up, and like, you can tell that I've been sleeping because it's flat over here, but it's calm. Day two. I don't know if it's in focus. We'll see later. What is it? Oh, it's cute! That is adorable. They're little houses. Oh, I love them. Okay. In my backyard. Okay. I love it. I also like the texture. I don't know if you can see that texture, but it's like gridded. I don't know. I love it. Okay, I made a mistake yesterday. We're gonna post this on Instagram first and then do the planner. And then I'll show you the planner afterwards. It's too much of a hassle to do all of it together at once. There's just a lot going on. I'm pleased with how short it is. It's a good length, I think. My mom's gonna freak. Oh well, it's 6:45. It's 6:45. And I'm fairly happy. I got everything I needed to get done today done. I took my final oral exam in Korean. I think I got it. I at least have a B. I've passed that class. I finished my assignment 4 for psychology. What else did I do today? That's about it. I had 2 meetings. I didn't gain much from them. They were required meetings. I needed to have a certain number of meetings for me to pass that class, so I did that. I did some work for my other classes so that it'll be easier tomorrow. And I did my monthly layout in my passion planner, because that was necessary. It was really an excuse to use these stickers. Aren't they cute? These came in the monthly subscription, so I have that done. I filled out the front of it, but it's kind of personal, so like, you're not gonna see that. I made a YouTube, this didn't happen today, but it has happened. I made a YouTube plan, so this is the amount of days that I'm going to be posting on my main channel. And then these are video ideas. And then it's in pencil, so when I finish it, I can put it in pen. And when it's in pencil, I can move it around. I also have created new logos, intros and outros, and banners for my YouTube channels for 2022. Because I had time. I had time. And I wanted to. So, although I'm going to have to do them more, if that makes sense, because I'm using a free trial of a program and I want to use it up until, like, I don't want to have to pay for it. It is only $4 though, so I might end up paying for it just until I have everything done. We'll see, so that I can have that done. And I might use the same program to make thumbnails, but I'm not sure. We shall see about that. Let's see. I don't know if I want to use it to make thumbnails, because I don't like making thumbnails. That's the biggest thing. Ooh, I can update, so many things. I can update story highlight covers. Okay, there's a lot of things that I need to look at that I don't have the time to look at now. Like, it doesn't have to happen right now. But I will be looking at them because I do like the way that they look. Great, okay. Well, that's something I'll be continuing to do. I spent six minutes not doing anything. I spent six time. Anyway, I just wanted to say that I got a lot done today and I'm kind of proud of it. And I'll see you tomorrow when I get to open my advent calendar again. I haven't even snuck a peek at the color palette this time. I'm really loving the independent artists. I'm linking all of them, their Instagrams, in my Instagram stories. It'll be on @messy.study.guide under the story highlight advent 2021 or 2021 advent. I'm not sure which one I've done. And then hopefully at some point soon there will be new story covers on that. I don't know what my hair is doing, but you know, I'm enjoying it. It's the third. I haven't even snuck a peek. Sometimes I lift up the flap so that, like, through the little gap I can see the color scheme. Haven't done that this time. You ready? 3. This is so hard to do without looking. I don't know why I do it like this. Ba, 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 ba. That was bad. Oh, these are cute. Oh, they are very cute. They're little, like, I want to call them medicine bottles. I have no better word for them than that. With flowers. Chamomile, lavendule. It's got the, I'm gonna go out on a limb and say that it's Latin. It's got the Latin names of the flowers. Ooh, this is very exciting. I'm gonna move this. Okay, I'm gonna make a spread for that. How do I want to go about this? Because it's got the tan background. So I have all of these out already. Do I want to use any of them? I kind of want to do like a contrasting color because it's all one color here. Oh no, I have an idea. I just woke up. The book Skinship has become available from my local library. I've had it on hold for a while, so I'm putting a pause on Anna Karenina so I can read that instead. Also, Anna Karenina is just boring to me. I'm not having a good time. I've read the first chapter of Skinship. It's really good. And then it's also the fourth, which means it's time for day four. Do 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 do. What are you? You're cute, is what you are. They're little animals in the stars. Man, that's cool. Are we gonna focus? Here we go. I really like these. These are really cool. They're so soft looking. Man, okay. Well, artists are cool. I'm going to set up my planner. I'm going to set it up with these ones, and then Sundays I'll have for some other time. Because I don't think I'm going to create a separate spread for Saturday and Sunday. I think I'm just going to do a weekend spread like I normally do. I'm almost done with the semester. It's very exciting. This is how it be today. I'm tired and I don't really want to do anything, but I do have stickers. I'm very excited for them. I'm just probably not going to do anything with them today. I might do something with them tomorrow. We shall see. E4, it's the 5th, right? Yeah, it's the 5th. The 5th. Are we ready? Oh, they're cute. There's a bird outside. I want to say, well, some of them have jackets that are not quite 1800s, but I want to say 1800s and then like late 18, early 1900s. Except we've got a Regency lady up in the corner. I don't know. We've got vaguely Victorian. We've got women and men from other times in the past. I like this. Very cute. I'm not gonna use them today. I might use them tomorrow. Or I might use tomorrow's tomorrow. Who knows? Anyway, today I'm gonna lie down some more. And then when I feel like getting up, I'm gonna get up. And then I'm gonna do laundry and sort of tidy. Because it's a mess in here. So you'll probably join me on that if it gets done today. You can tell that I've been lying like this. You see the imprint of my pillow. Anyway, I'm gonna go back to lying down. I'm really tired. What is it, day six? Day six. I cut my nails yesterday, so this is gonna be difficult. There we go. Oh my goodness. We got posh cats. And posh rabbits. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Okay, well, I love them. They're very cute. I ended up making a spread yesterday that I'm using today. I think I'm just gonna keep making spreads, so I'll have 25 spreads by the end of this, and then I'll just use them when I need to. That way I use the stickers. Just a thought. I go to school today. It's Monday. It's Monday, and this is the last week of class, so I'm definitely going in even though I feel awful. I think my period is coming, and that's why I feel so terrible. I think my period's coming and that's why I feel so terrible, but we shall see. I go home not at the end of this week, but at the end of next week. And then I'm at home for about a week. I'm gonna see Jess and Sid. And then I'm gonna have Christmas at my grandparents. And then I'm gonna pick up George from somewhere and we can go down Highway 1, having a little road trip. We've been wanting to do this since I was in Cornish, I think. And it just never worked out. But now that I have a reliable car, because the green car was reliable up until a point, now I have a reliable car and I have the time. Because with the black car, it was definitely reliable. Work was awful and I could not get that much time off from work. And then she moved to Portland, so we saw each other even less. And then I moved to Arizona, and so it became even more difficult to see each other. So now I have a reliable car, and we're gonna be in the same place at the same time, because her work let her off. And I have winter break. I'm not taking winter classes. I will be taking summer classes though. So I'm very excited for that. I'm going to share these on Instagram and maybe make a spread, maybe just go to class and make a spread later tonight. And I will see you guys tomorrow if I don't see you some other time today. Hello. I should have cleaned off the desk before I started this because now I'm distracted. It's day 7. It's a week into Thanksgiving. Into December. Here we go. Oh no. Oh, they're too pretty. This one button is really annoying me, so I'm just gonna button this up, then we'll go back to that. These are so pretty. Okay, well, I'm gonna make a spread. I've decided I'm just gonna make a spread every single day and then use them when I need to. Did I already say that? I don't know. That way I use all of the stickers, because what else am I gonna do with the stickers? Might as well just use them. These are really pretty. Okay, I'm gonna go because I talk way too long on these and I don't really film anything else, so it's gonna get boring. Anyway, these are gorgeous. They're so pretty. And I'm gonna go. My goal aesthetic is to look like your gay English teacher, and I think I'm nailing it. When you light. There we go. Now you can see the shinies. It is the 8th. Oh, I need to charge this. The 8th. Oh, it is chilly outside today. I say it's chilly. It's probably like 60 degrees. Okay, 8th. I have an exam today. I'm not excited. Oh, they're so cute. I have an exam today. I'm not excited. But these are cute. These are really cute. Oh my goodness. Close. Come on. There we go. They're little cakeys. They're little cakes. They're so cute. I'm chilly and I have an exam, so I'm gonna go now and I'll catch y'all later. Wait till you see my hair. Okay. It is the 9th, right? I realize there's an easy way of doing that, and that's to check the pocket of the one before. I don't know why I didn't think of that before. Okay, 9. Ooh, this is a pretty pouch. Why can't I? Oh, there it is. Oh, you wouldn't be able to see that at all. The Traveler. It's a bunch of... Oh, wait, I remember this artist. Oh, this is really cute. It's like travel things. This is really cute. I'm gonna put them in my planner, obviously, because, you know. Oh, I was like, there's no tape over here. Today, I am going to take my psychology exam so that I have it done. And then psychology's done for the year. And then I'm going to Marico with Will for lunch-ish. My cactus isn't doing too hot, and I feel really bad for it. I don't know what to do. He's droopy. But I'm going to continue making spreads. And I'll see you guys when I see you. Well, I don't know. This is a tired update, and the answer of today is I'm tired. Today's just gonna be loud because it's raining, so you're just gonna have to deal with that. It's also gonna be dark because it's raining. It's day 10.
I'm pretty sure. It is. Is it? Is it not? Is it the 9th?
No, it's the 10th. We're good.
Cute. It's colorful. Okay, I'm gonna turn on the light so maybe you can see.
This is very, very pretty. Very colorful. I like how prominent the blues and the reds and the greens are. Like, it's not muted, it's like, I'm green, I'm blue. I appreciate that. I think it's really pretty. VasillaArt.com. It doesn't have an Instagram. I want to credit them on Instagram. I'll look them up and see if they have an Instagram that just isn't included on this. I don't know why it wouldn't be. Because I don't want to just post it and not have any credit. Anyway, I'm gonna go curl up in bed. I'm in a drama watching rut. I've watched a lot of dramas like back to back, and now I can't get into anything new. Like, even ones that I've watched before, I can't get into it. I can't get into new ones, I can't get into old ones, so I think I'm gonna take a break and watch YouTube. I have like 500 in my watch later list. I'm saving... Oh, we're really not doing well. I'm saving Bake Off, the new season of Bake Off, for home so I can watch it with my parents, because generally that's what we watch when we're eating dinner. I'm not on Twitter, so I have... No spoilers. I don't follow the right people on Instagram. Well, the right people in order to get spoilers. So I'm completely spoiler free because I live in a socially isolated bubble. It's a bonus for being an introvert is that you don't get spoiled. I think my plants might need more water. I don't know. I don't think so. I think they're just being dramatic. This one might actually need more water, though, because there's so many of him. Grover is huge, so we might need more water for Grover. I don't know. We'll see how he does after the rain is over, because it might be a pressure change. I don't know. The rest of them look fine, and they've all been getting the same amount of water. Like, they get watered at the same time. Maybe I need to water him more frequently. I don't know. Okay. Elkie is having a hard time. They grew too fast, too tall, too fast, and now is just, we're having a hard time. And I don't know what to do to help you. I want to help you, I don't know how to. Also, there's tiny Elkie down there who's doing just fine. But this one, he just grew way too tall, way too fast, and now is struggling. And like, did I contribute to that? Maybe, I watered him a lot. Maybe he thought he didn't need to make any stores. He tried here. I don't know. And now I'm emotionally invested in these cacti. So, also his spines are falling off. I think he might be dying. I might go without watering them for a little bit just to see if that helps. But the other ones need water. I'm gonna go play The Sims. Maybe. I'm trying to make a self-made millionaire with someone who just works on a farm. She's currently going to class part-time. She has one class per semester,
so I don't think she's going to graduate in time for it to actually count. But the scholarships that she's eligible for are huge. So I'm kind of working the system. So she gets the scholarships. She only takes one class a term. The scholarships more than pay for it. So that's extra income every semester. So that's what we're doing. That's why you can't do that in the real world. Because otherwise, my aunt fogged up my glasses. I gotta go. Are still going, so we're just gonna head right on over into, what day is it? The 11th! 11. I don't know why I do it this way. Let me in. Okay. Okay. No! Let me in. There we go. Oh, these are so pretty. I love these. Okay. I love these. I can't wait to use them. My roommates want to see them, so I'm gonna end it here, which is super fast, but you know, do what needs to be did. What? I'll see you later. Or not. So as many of you know, who know me personally, I'm really bad with names and faces, and especially with actors, because if they change their look, even in the slightest, I cannot figure out who it is. I have to look for something else to focus on. It's one of the biggest issues that I have with K-pop groups.
because they change their hair and their makeup so frequently that unless I have some other kind of like emotion attached to them, I can't figure out who's who. But eventually I get like an emotion associated with them, or like I hear their voice and there's like a color associated with their voice. And so I can figure out who it is. But when I'm watching a drama and I see someone who I hate so very, very much, I can't figure out where I saw them to make me hate them so much. And I've never seen this drama before, so I haven't seen this drama before. I haven't seen this actor in this role, but why do I hate him? Like, oh, I don't even know what his role is. We've only had a single phone conversation with him. He's a medical examiner, and I dislike him so much. I don't know why.
It's the game towards zero, and it's this medical examiner. Why don't I like him?
I had the same emotion with the lawyer friend in Suspicious Partner with the brown hair. And it took me watching Suspicious Partner maybe 3-4 times before I realized that that actor is the same actor who was in Missing 9, who killed his friends on the island. Sorry, I spoiled that movie for you, or that drama. I don't know where you can watch it anymore, so like, did I really spoil it? Or, because it was on Drama Fever. I don't know if it's up anywhere. I'm gonna go look for it, because I liked that one. The music in that was fantastic. I found him. He's in Oh My Ghost. He's the one who's possessed in Oh My Ghost. He's the one who has the creepy ringtone. Oh man, I had to do some Googling. I didn't know his name. His name is Lim Ju Hwan. He's in a lot of things that I've seen. The Bride of Hibok. I don't have an emotion associated with that. Uncontrollably Fond, I didn't associate him with that. Oh My Ghost is where I got it. Absolutely. He's in Boys Over Flowers. A, I hated that drama, but B, I don't remember. See, this is my problem. Unless you create like a color in my head or an emotional, like physical feeling, I'm not gonna know who the frick you are. Ever. Whether it's, a lot of people are like, oh, you just can't tell because they're Asian. No, I have that with white people too, unless I have a color associated with a voice or an emotion attached to their being. I don't know who they are. I think the most common one is Bill Murray and Tom Hanks. They're the same person. They have the same feeling. They have the same color. I cannot tell them apart at all. I have a bug bite on the lobe of my ear and it's really bothering me. I keep playing with it.
Hello? Am I sinking or did I? Yeah, I'm sinking. That's what happened there. It's like, I thought I just set it up. I think it's the 13th. I'm incorrect. It is the 12th. Did I open it yesterday? I did. I tore it. I'm opening it facing down this time, at least the flap, just so that I don't struggle again. Precious. Those are really precious. They're like little elves. I really like the texture. Like, there's not a lot of detail, there's just enough detail to get the point across. I love it. I really do. My period just started, so I'm shaking like crazy. This is really pretty. I really like these. They're really sweet. I'm gonna go curl up in bed some more. Yeah, I'm tired. I'm just gonna curl up in bed. I will see you the next time that I see you, which will probably be tomorrow. I don't foresee anything happening today that I want to share. I might go to Starbucks today. No, I don't think I'm gonna want... I could go today and then be okay. I don't know if today or tomorrow is gonna be like the pain day, you know? Because it's normally about 12 hours after the period started, but it started last night, so I'm not entirely sure when it started. So I don't know if it's going to be painful today, tonight, or tomorrow. So I can't guarantee, but at some point this not weekend, I'm going to be going to Starbucks. I have an exam on Tuesday. Today is Sunday. I've got time. I need to finish my essay for that class, and then it'll be good. All I need to do is write the conclusion. That should be fairly simple. I'm gonna go. My hair is defying gravity. It won't go down. I don't know what to do with it. Anyway, it's the 13th, it's a Monday, and I'm forcing myself to do stuff today so that I can get stuff done. That worked. Ish. This is the 12th. Today is the 13th. I like this page. I hit record. Oh, pretty. Bravo. These are really cute. I'm sinking. These are really cute. I like the gold detail. I like the masks. I'm a stickler for like ballet shoes, but I get that this is an artistic rendition, and so I'm gonna leave it alone. I have like 11 things on my to-do list. 12 things on my to-do list today. I need to put away my laundry, take out the garbage, because this room is filled with junk. I'm going to make my bed. Oh, that's a 13th thing. Then I have a bunch of Korean bits that I need to get done so that I can stay on top of my Korean learning journey. And then I have a meeting with my study abroad advisor. Hopefully this time next year, I will be in South Korea. But who knows? Not me. That's why I'm talking to the advisor. With Omicron, there's a whole lot of new hurdles that need to be navigated before I can go. So hopefully I'll be able to go. I want to go. And we shall see. But yeah, today I have a lot that needs to get done. I also might walk to Starbucks just to do something. So let's get started. I moved you into the closet yesterday to film a time lapse, and I don't feel like moving you out of the closet, so you're staying in the closet. Welcome to this new angle. It is the 14th. I just took an exam. I think I got a B on it. I'm not sure. That class, I'm probably gonna get a B, which is kind of upsetting because I was going to have straight A's. But you know, it happens. It's the 14th. Are you ready? We got fancy eyeballs. I really like these. They're really cool. Thank you, Ruth Spear, for the design. I'm gonna go put them in my planner. And then I'm gonna play The Sims, because now my last exam is done. What really do I have to do? I have to apply for my study abroad. That's what I have to do. That happens tomorrow. That's not a today problem. That's a tomorrow problem. I'll see y'all later. Hello. Welcome. I found a new way of getting my hat on my face, and it involves a clip. You know the feeling when a headache is approaching? That's what I'm feeling right now. It is the 15th. This is the 14th. It is the 15th. Oh my goodness. We've got animals and nature. I really like the fox whose tail sort of turns into the leaves, or the deer of some kind whose antlers are also branches. I really like that. This is really pretty. Today is attempt to apply for study abroad. The website is currently down, which is why I say attempt. The website for like the university student access for grades is also supposed to go up today, and it is also down. So I feel like the two might be connected, because I feel like more students are trying to see their grades than they are trying to apply to go to this one specific university in South Korea. Just saying, I think the two might be connected. So we will continue trying.
Let's do a currently doing thing. So I'm currently still reading Anna Karenina. I'm about 80% done. We're almost there. I haven't been so bored reading a book since I read Moby Dick. I'm currently watching three things. So I'm watching a Thai drama called Waterboy because happy and gay. That's it. That's the only reason. I'm watching a K-drama called Towards Zero, or The Game Towards Zero, which is part of the reason why I need something happy. So I watch Towards Zero when I get up in the morning. It's like a murder mystery, but it's super creepy. And then before I go to bed, I can't watch that, so I'm watching Waterboy at that point, so I don't have awful dreams. I've been having weird dreams, but not awful dreams. And then when I'm sewing, because I can't see the screen, and right now the K-drama is using a lot of police jargon that I just don't understand, I'm watching an English TV show called Tiny House Nation, which doesn't require a whole lot of I need to see what's happening, so I can focus on the sewing. I'm currently listening to literally everything. I have all of my music on shuffle, and I listen to the, and then I have a playlist of the least recently listened to on my iTunes. So I listen to those, and right now I have a whole bunch of like old K-pop, like 2012 K-pop, and a whole lot of classical music. I think the last time I listened to most of these songs was in 2016, which, brace yourself, was 5 years ago. So I'm listening to a whole lot of that right now, and it's been a real fun journey. I'm really enjoying the classical. I realize why I enjoyed it so much. I'm enjoying the K-pop with the nostalgia of it, but it's not good. It's amazing that that's what got me hooked. To be fair, what got me hooked was Big Bang, Super Junior, and SHINee, and TVXQ. And those are good. And then BTS came along and 24K came along, and I was like, solid, we're good. Also, there was Mamamoo, and there was, what was CLN? What was that group called? Now I just have CL's discography stuck in my head. It's not CLC, that came later. Anyway, I cannot for the life of me remember what that is. But that's what I've been listening to. I've also been listening to my podcasts. I listen to Up First by NPR, and then I listen to Consider This by NPR, and Wait Wait Don't Tell Me by NPR. Those are my news coverage podcasts. Then I have This Might Get Weird, which is Grace Helbig and Mamrie Hart. I listen to Crime Junkie. I listen to Dear Hank and John with the Green Brothers. That one makes me smile so much. I absolutely love that podcast. I listen to You Can Sit With Us with the Try Wives, and I listen to The Tripod, which is the Try Guys podcast. I had a lot more murder mystery podcasts, but they all moved to Spotify exclusively, and I just don't have the time for that. I listen to Talk to Me in Korean, their podcast, their 100% in Korean podcast, Iyagi Time. Essentially, there's a different podcast uploads on a different day of the week, all throughout the week, with the exception of Sunday. So that's a good time. I listen to my NPR podcast, the Up First and Consider This. Those are every day, except Sunday. And then I listen to another podcast after I listen to the news. It works out. Well, while the train does its thing, I'm going to get going with my work, so I'll see y'all later.
I have to drive my car somewhere, so I'm gonna go shopping. I'm gonna pick up tuna, I think, and Wheat Thins. Enough for traveling home, because I don't like stopping places when I drive. So I'm just gonna pick up some things to have in the hotel room when I go home, because I'm going halfway and then I'm going all the way, because it'll take about 8 hours to get to the hotel and then 8 hours to get from the hotel to home. And I don't want to do 16 hours in one day. So, but my car's check engine light went on when I was coming home from Sedona, coming here from Sedona.
So I'm just gonna drive it to see if it comes on again, to see how exactly I'm getting home.
I made it to Safeway. I feel a whole lot more confident driving, which is very nice, especially since I'm about to go on a 16-hour car ride home. I'm going to see what I can get that I can take with me so it doesn't have to be refrigerated, that I can eat in one serving, because I'm thinking I'm going to need... I'll get breakfast here, like Starbucks or something, because I don't leave until about 10, and then I'm not going to stop, is the thing. So I need something to potentially eat in the car as I'm driving, probably like crackers, and then something to eat when I get to the room, which doesn't have to be refrigerated, which is why I'm thinking tuna. So if I get like a lot of wheat thins and some tuna, then I have that. But then I'm gonna need breakfast for the next day. But then again, no, I'm thinking of the wrong place. I could get Starbucks on the way as well. There's a person. Like, I could find a Starbucks somewhere and get that for breakfast, or I could pack something for breakfast, like get, what is today? I leave on the 18th. Today is the 16th. So something that I could eat some of, 16, 17, 18, 19. So like a 4-pack of muffins would work. I just couldn't eat all of them at once. But I need something because I'm anxious, you know? So I'm gonna go find... I have an awfully painful pimple, so I've put the pimple patch on it, and I hope it'll go away, but like every time I talk, it hurts. The one on my ear has kind of gone away. I mean, it's not as painful as before, you can still clearly see it. And I have all of them here and here. Just one, I think I need to clean my pillowcase. Two, my period is being a bitch this week, or this month. Like, it was 2 weeks late. Which is already upsetting. And then it does this? Who gave you the permission? I made it. I got a little lost on the way home. I took a left one light sooner than I was supposed to, but it worked out okay. I went in and out of the grocery store really fast. I got 2 cans of tuna, a can of SpaghettiOs, tortillas, ketchup, Wheat Thins. Just, I can bring the tortillas home with me. So I have food, and I just have to remember to bring a can opener with me. I might open a can of beans today, eat it for the rest of the week, and then put the can opener like already in my suitcase so I don't even have to think about it.
Another thing. I put the keys to my house in California somewhere where I wouldn't lose them, but I don't remember where that place is. So, I think it's something that I would have had with me. I feel like it was a drawer, but the only drawers I have are my clothes drawers, and they're definitely not in there because I use those frequently. I'm thinking maybe in a backpack. Maybe in this one? Because I don't use it very often, so it wasn't likely to get lost. Oh! I found them. Do I put them back where I had them before? Yes. Otherwise, I'm gonna lose them again. They're going back in this bag. Okay, well, they're now in my green bag, and if I forget again, I've told you where they are, and so I can watch this back. They're in your green bag, Kat. Green bag. While I'm still upright, it's the 16th. It's the 16th. I can't, my hat's in the way. These are pretty. I like how it's watercolor. I'm gonna use this today. Oh, it's the same one who did the lavender and honey. That's why this notepad that I use, that's why the art style is so familiar. I was like, I feel like I recognize this same person. I really like their work. So I'm gonna go get horizontal again, and then I'll do something with this. I'm almost done finishing the quilt that I'm sewing for my Aunt Christine. I need to put my groceries away as well. And, oh, I finished Anna Karenina. I was bored almost the entire time. For a book called Anna Karenina, it's not really about Anna Karenina. And now I'm on to Rebecca, which hopefully is about Rebecca. Because if not, I don't know what I'm gonna do. Well, I know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna finish the book, but like, you know what I mean. Good morning. I made myself get up today. I took a shower. I don't know what my hair is doing. It's doing this thing.
I started my laundry. Today is going to be a day. I'm going to get it done. But first, it is the 17th. This is the 16th. It is the 17th. It's almost Christmas? What the heck? What is this? Anyway, it's the 17th. Time to open up this. I love this. Not gonna lie, but the bat is my favorite one. Hookie Duke, Erica Williams. I love these. Man, the deer with the books, great. You know what I forgot to do yesterday? I forgot to take a picture of the sticker sheet before I used them, and I'm really upset with myself for having done that. So we're gonna not forget this time. Like I said, today is gonna be a day. I have quite a bit planned for today. I'm trying to film 3 different videos today and edit at least one of them so that I don't have to worry about it over Christmas break, because I'm just trying to get back on schedule. I upload every other week on my main channel. I'm just trying to get back to that because I do enjoy doing it. I enjoy making the videos and I enjoy editing the videos. Whether anybody watches them or not really doesn't matter to me because I'm having a good time with it. So, and then I leave tomorrow for home. So I also have to pack today. What? I'm torn between leaving around 10 o'clock to make sure I get there at 4 so that I can check in immediately, or leaving at 6 o'clock, getting there early, and just hanging out, because I need to put gas in my car, and I need to get through Phoenix, and I don't know if I want to do that in the afternoon. But I'm thinking what I can do is get gas early in the morning, come back here, go out, get breakfast somewhere, come back, and then leave. I'm thinking maybe that's the way to go, because that way I don't have to go to the gas station while everybody else is at the gas station, because that's literally my worst nightmare. But also, I'm not getting to the hotel way, way too early and having to sit in my car waiting for check-in time. So I think that's the way I'm gonna go. I'm currently reading Rebecca. It's interesting. I'm having a good time. I'm getting weird feelings about Mr. De Winter. I feel like it's gonna be one of those situations where he has the body of his dead wife sitting in his old bedroom because he just misses her so much. I know she drowned, but was she found? I don't know. I'll see you guys when I see you, probably when I do a time lapse making my bed and or putting away my laundry, because I like doing those. It's satisfying for me to watch, and it forces me to actually do it because I'm aware that someone else is watching me.
I got all A's on 18 credits. So now I'm treating myself to some pizza.
I just remembered that Dad wanted me to pick up salami from Time Market before I go home. So that's what I'm gonna go do now, because I finished my pizza. And like, what else am I gonna do? Sit and edit in my room? I could make my bed. I don't want to right now. I'll do it when I get back. What I do need to do is take some of these boxes out, because we're slowly working our way through all of them. Theoretically, I could take them all out at once, but I don't want to. So, we're gonna take these ones out. And we're just going to Time Market. So, what do I need? I need my keys and a mask. And you. You're coming with me. While I was down there, I picked up the mail. I got mail. So I'm gonna do it here instead of going over to my desk. Because why not? You're already here. So the first thing is from Sticky. Oh, yay. I'm so excited for this. It's the January pack. Sorry, I stuck a peek. It's one of the artists that I really liked from the advent calendar. Okay, first we have a notepad. It's another artist that I really like from the calendar. Here we go. Reading. Little notepad, I'm gonna put it up on my wall. This theme is plein air is French. Interesting. Don't know how to pronounce it. We have little bookmarks. Let me in with... You're definitely not going to be able to see this. It's got little hot air balloons on them. This is really cute. I really like these. I'm going to put them with the rest of my bookmarks, which means for right now, they're going on my bed. Okay, on to the next thing. It looks like the next thing is a little card, which is very pretty, by that same artist that I was telling you about. Grace Muir Woods. Freaking love her stuff. So this is going out to somebody. Onto the stickers. We have more stickers by Grace Muir Woods. She did the dough and the other guys that I have, and I absolutely love it. Her work is very pretty. I follow her on Instagram now because I love seeing what she does. Okay, next are these little butterfly tabs. I don't know if this is focused or not, but you get the drift. See, I think I know what's in the bigger package, and I think it's tabs for my planner, but maybe I can use these ones too, because these are really pretty. Okay, next is, we got little seascapes and skyscapes. Just, you know, scapes. They're so pretty. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Okay, and then we have, oh my goodness, these are adorable. We have Explorer Cats. And hot air balloons with eggs, like Fabergé eggs, but hot air balloons. We have a sextant, we have a compass, we have a little map. These are really cute. I really like those. Oh, they're shiny. We have teapots that are, they're teapots, but they're also lighthouses. And it's shimmery. You're not gonna be able to pick up on the shimmery, but it's also shimmery. Are we gonna focus? I'm gonna make you focus. Focus. They're teapots, but they're also lighthouses. Love them. 10 out of 10. Okay, and then we have the Bacati, which is another, I love her artwork. It's another one who, or their artwork, who I saw in the bullet journal. Or not the bullet journal, in the advent calendar. And they're little tree houses and owls and, you know, just guys. They're little guys. And then finally we have, oh, it's on another shiny paper, some hands holding planets. Which I also love. Those are fantastic. I love all of these stickers. Can't wait to use them. I'm gonna put them in my sticker binder. Y'all, I need a new binder. This one's getting a little full. I'm gonna need a new binder. Okay, next is this package, which I think is from Passion Planner, because I ordered those tabs, skeezers. Those are my paper and crafting scissors. My yarn and sewing scissors are with my yarn and sewing projects. Yes, I do own 4 pairs of scissors. And they all have different uses. I was gonna dramatically pull this off, but I couldn't get a hold of it. And they all have different uses. I'm glad I make myself laugh, because otherwise, you know, otherwise. Ooh. Here we go. We're out. This is the Flush Monthly Tabs in Earthy Neutrals. Here they are. Ba 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 ba. These are from Passion Planner. They go directly on the page. They don't leave out a tab. You just see it from the outside. And it has all of the months in a year plus some extras. So I'm probably going to use these in my daily to separate the months from here to here, like in the daily pages. And then probably use the other ones to mark where the extra pages begin. I don't really need pages to mark out or anything to mark out the monthly pages because they're all right next to each other. But I could probably use one of the tabs to mark the beginning of the monthlies. Maybe not. Anyway, we'll see how I use them. If I don't use them in this, I'll be using them in my weekly one. Where did I put that one? Oh, it's down there. When I go back to doing weekly. Either way, I'm excited for them and they're gonna go in the back pocket in here. Will they fit? They'll fit. I'm not saying I'm obsessed with planning and with stickers, but I'm kind of obsessed with planning and stickers. Ta-da! So now I'm gonna go make my bed because Well, I took all the sheets off of it to wash them, but I want to go to bed in my sheets. So I need to make my bed. That's how that works. And then, I don't know, maybe I'll finish editing. Today has been very productive. I've got basically everything I wanted to get done today done, which, wow. Good for you, Kat. Pat yourself on the back. So, but the thing is, I got everything that I want to get done today done, and it's only 3 o'clock. I guess that just means I can go to bed early, right? I can retire early. I'll see you guys probably tomorrow, if not later tonight. I'll definitely talk to you tomorrow. How about that?
It's 5 o'clock in the morning and I'm just gonna go get gas and then come back because I forgot to do that yesterday, and 5 o'clock in the morning on a Saturday, I'm really hoping there's not a lot of people at the gas station. Let's see. Don't be fooled by the fact that you're in the same exact location now. I went, I got gas. It was kind of sketchy. You know how gas station, like the stores attached to them are almost always open? This one wasn't, and I don't know how to feel about that. But I got gas, so there's that. I might be looking for another gas station. The 7-Eleven has a gas station right next to the Safeway that I go to, so I might go there instead of this place that was directly off the freeway. That's a little bit closer. Just because I've seen people go to the 7-Eleven, and as I was pumping gas, I realized I never saw anybody pump gas from that station. Not that I go out very frequently, but I've just never seen it. So maybe next time I will go somewhere else. But also, it's now 5:20. I'm not gonna say I'm gonna go to bed because my sleep was kind of awful. I had so many weird dreams. The one I most vividly remember is being on this campus, but there were sections of this campus that you had to swim through to get to classes, and I just didn't know that. So I was like, I legitimately can't find these classes, so I'm just gonna drop them. And then I ate something that I didn't like, so I put foaming soap in my mouth, but it wouldn't stop foaming, so I just had like foam in my mouth, and the whole rest of the dream was me just trying to figure out how to get the foam out of my mouth. And it wasn't working. I was like digging with my hands, I was putting water in there and swishing and like getting some out. It wasn't working. So I'm not sure I want to go to sleep and go back to that, but I will be lying down. It's about 8 o'clock and I'm gonna leave at about 10 o'clock. But what I wanna do first is eat, A. B, I need to wash dishes and like clean up a little bit. And then I also want to walk to CVS and pick up like caffeine, probably Dr. Pepper, Mountain Dew, so that I can have it on my drive. I don't think I'm gonna pick up Starbucks. I think I'll pick up Starbucks maybe tomorrow, maybe not, I don't know, but the caffeine should be fine. Tomorrow, I really want to leave super early in the morning because I really don't like waiting around like this. I feel like I'm going to be late for something, even though there's literally no time that I'm supposed to be anywhere. I really hate it. So I'm going to get dressed, walk to CVS. When I come back, I'll eat, and then I'll do all the dishes at once and start loading up the car and taking out all of the trash because I don't want it to smell when I come back.
The check engine light in my car went on, so I've stopped at a gas station. I don't need gas. I mean, I guess I could fill it up. What I'm gonna do is let the car cool down a little bit. I checked the oil. The oil is fine. I checked the fuses. The fuses are fine. I unscrewed and then re-screwed the gas cap because sometimes when that's loose, the light will come on. I'm not entirely sure what's going on. I'm gonna let the engine cool off. I'm probably gonna go to the bathroom and maybe pick up some Mountain Dew and then see if it goes on again. So that's my plan. We'll see how it goes.
I've arrived. So now I'm gonna show you the room because it's actually pretty freaking cool. I have an AA room, like an accessible room. So we've got a peephole down here and a peephole up here, but there's nothing up here, which is where they normally is. It's at my level, which I appreciate. Everything in this space is at my level. Love it. So coming in, we have all of the cabinets for the kitchen. You've got the toaster, the blender, the cups, the bowls. Again, everything is at some place where I can reach. I know it's not for me, but you know. This is really cool. It's a pull-out cutting board. Look at that. Wow. More cabinets with some pots and pans and stuff. Trash. Sink. It's a big sink. It's also low. It's at my hip level. You can't see that.
We got a stovetop. I'm not going to use any of these things. I like this. This is fun. It's got a little knob. Dishwasher. Don't need it. That's the food that I brought. A fridge and a freezer. I put the salami and my caffeine in there. And then, so this is like the kitchen hallway. And then you've got a little seat in this corner. Those blinds go up, so from the bed you can see outside. We've got a TV, a little ottoman, a little desk, a lovely bed, this picture of a golf ball, and an actual golf ball. The view, you can kind of see, I'm not gonna open, but the golf course is out there. We've got a closet, a table. I've put my plants down here. They were getting sun a little while ago, but the sun's going down, so they're not getting any right now. Then we have a bathroom. The bathtub is really low, which is a little bit disappointing because I kind of wanted to take a bath, but I can take a bath when we get home. I don't know where the lights are. Here they are. Okay, so the shower has a shower head and then a separate shower head that can be pulled off because it's AA, so it has all of these things. I think one of these goes to one shower head, one of these goes to the other shower head. I don't know what that is. I'll figure it out later. Toilet, doors, door handles, very low. Sink, mirror, hello. And there's a second door that goes into the bedroom, so you can access the bathroom from both the living area and the bedroom. The bed has this spotlight. There's cookies and cream. I don't go anywhere without her. I am a 23-year-old adult. We've got a fun chair. It's got a little footrest. It's really comfortable. Another TV, another closet. And my favorite thing, this door. This door rolls closed. And it does it nicely too. And then when you open it, I think I figured out what's wrong with my car. I think it's low on oil. I don't know where to get oil or how to fill the car up with oil. So I'm just gonna go for it and hope for the best. Like, it's not dangerously low, but it is kind of low. And the check engine light is no longer flashing. It's just on. So I might Google where to get oil, but I don't know what kind of oil to put in my car either. So we'll Google it and figure it out. I was planning on leaving at 2 a.m, but if I have to do oil, I guess I could do it before I go to sleep. I'll figure it out.
So my car's being finicky again. I'm not sure what it is. I kind of have to go to the bathroom now that I'm stopped and I'm thinking about it. Do I go into the Mickey D's and get something to use their bathroom? Or do I wait? I'm gonna use the bathroom. But first, it'll give my car time to, like, chill out. The check engine light is on again. I got it to go off, and I thought we were all good, and now we aren't again. So I'm not entirely sure what's up with it. The fact that it turns off and then turns back on again is making me feel like it's something that is not urgent. And it also turns off again, or it turns on when I turn off cruise control and accelerate. So I'm thinking that might have something to do with that. I don't know. I'm gonna turn it on and see if the check engine light's on. It's on again, but it's not blinking, and it's yellow. So I'm gonna give it some more time, and I'm gonna use the bathroom. And then I'm gonna come back, I'm gonna open up my gasket thing, I'm gonna open up the gas thing, and then close it and see if that helps, because that helped last time. So we shall see. But first, I'm going to go use the bathroom. Do I have to buy anything to use the bathroom? Are they checking if people are buying things before they pee? We'll see. They do not, in fact, check if you've bought anything. I feel better now, and I'm going to try this again. We're still on, but you know what? We're gonna call it good. It's 2 hours till home. I'll see you there. And I'll do both stickers at once. I realized that I forgot to do stickers. I've got other things on my mind. I'll do stickers when I get home.